Hi, Julie. We know that trees can provide so many benefits. Without them, neighborhoods can be drier, they can be hotter, and sometimes we've seen that in more urban areas that just historically have not been as invested in. To change that, though, we need the data to prove it.
High above St. Louis Park, the tree canopy will soon be in full bloom, full of shade trees like this.
This is a common hackberry.
Common across the city, and where they're not, like the historic Rondo neighborhood, can sometimes be 15 degrees hotter, according to the Metropolitan Council.
Trees are working very hard for us. We don't often see the interconnections of all that they're providing, all the benefits.
Eric Wojcik helped design the growing shade tool to show where tree canopies are too thin due to disvestment or disease like the emerald ash borer infestation.
It's the first time we've had tree data that is updated constantly because we created this tool using satellite data.
Data that's helping cities prioritize where to plant more trees, like in St. Louis Park, the first city to offer trees, sometimes for free, and plant them on people's property to fill any canopy gaps.
We looked at age, we looked at current canopy cover, we looked at race data. That new data is really going to help us focus our efforts on that.
Hundreds of people already qualify for a tree delivered just today. That can come with a $200 price tag, add in planting costs, and that can double.
They need that background data to justify why they're providing incentives in different areas for lower or no cost trees. And that's exactly what this tool can do.
The Met Council calling it growing equitable change, one tree at a time.
It's important to try to preserve the trees we have and keep on planting for the future.
And the Met Council makes it really easy for people too. They made an interactive map that we posted in this story online, and all you have to do is search your address to see if you qualify for some of those discounted trees. If you do, there are a few rules, one of them being you have to keep the tree alive for the first 3 years.
So keep the tree alive. A little audio issues, but I think
that's what
you're saying.
Yeah.
Thanks, Jennifer.